14 defeat. Tyler Merriam joined down on the field by the head coach of South Dakota State, John Stiegelmeier. 300th game as a head coach at South Dakota State for you today, and what a win to celebrate it.
Yeah, I don't know those things. I guess that's what you guys do, but my celebration's through our players, and I thank God for those guys every day. And to walk into that locker room today, it was a special victory, and I'm happy for our program.
Your defense against an electric offensive team, averaging over 400 yards per game, you hold them to 258. They only had 30-some in the first half. The defense really played well today.
Defense played well, and the offense played well. We just didn't finish things in the first half, and that was part of the defense playing well. But I was really impressed with the entire time. I mean, still, they get some yards in the second half, but they came up with some big plays at some crucial times.
And again, we had talked earlier in the week about, hey, you only have 2 sacks in 3 games. Are you concerned? And you said no because of how things work. You got home today, you got home often, and you didn't have to do it blitzing 7 guys. Your front four really did the job.
Yeah, I was very impressed with our front four. Christian Smith and Jimmy do a great job with the package and then getting fresh guys in there. And I think, you know, to have 10 guys play D-line is really a special situation.
From an offensive standpoint, we want to highlight a couple of individuals. Zach Hines, career day, 7 receptions, 127 yards. The only time he had a ball thrown to him, he didn't catch it, was Gronowski threw one 10 feet over his head to get rid of it. Hines made every play possible. What a huge game the Sioux Falls native had.
He did. He's got great hands. He runs great routes. Some of those routes were designed for him to get the ball. Some of them were he's the second look, and he made the play. So credit to him and Mark, and then the fat guys blocking.
And Jaden Yonke, 8 receptions for 102 and 2 touchdowns. And, of course, he has that game-sealing grab where he turns upfield along the near sideline, tightropes it, and puts the game away.
Yeah, what a big play. And, you know, from our standpoint, you think he's running out of bounds, and all of a sudden somebody said he's still running. And so I'll look forward to seeing that on film.
In the fourth quarter today, Stig, you talk about putting things in perspective. Missouri State ran 6 plays for a total of 4 yards. You had 17 snaps for 154 yards. That's a pretty good recipe for winning a game on the road against a top 10 team.
It is. It is. And you know, our big guys take pride in that. And our entire coaching staff does such a great job of putting together a package. And again, credit Missouri State. They're a really good football team, but we came out on top, and like I said, I'm really proud of them.
And we should give a shout-out to Evan Berenson, his first collegiate start, and it's tough to do it on the road against a top 10 team, but he meshed with that offensive line really well today.
Yeah, Evan is an effort guy, and he's very athletic for an offensive lineman, and just happy for him. He struggled with some injuries earlier, and this is so important to him. So to get the plays in and to get the win is really special.
I do have to ask about a couple of plays in particular. One, a huge play in this game. Missouri State's going in to potentially tie the game early in the third quarter, and Colby Herter not only picks off a pass, but runs it down your sideline 70 yards.
Yeah, huge play in the game. You know, it's one of those deals. I talk to our coaches all the time that there are certain times quarterbacks see the receiver. They don't see the defender. I mean, threw it right at his chest. And then he was smart enough to get down the sidelines and make a guy miss. And huge play in the game because we scored on that ensuing possession.
And then an interesting play there at the end of the third quarter. You could have let the clock run out on fourth and short. You take an opportunity, and you had it open if Gronowski can pitch the ball to Davis, but they got some good penetration. You end up going over on downs.
Well, we fumbled the ball on the snap, and great design. You know, you get one shot of that play all season, and that was our shot, and we fumbled the ball. But again, I asked him in the locker room, can we play better? And 100%, yes, we can. And that's the cool part, to win on the road, to win against a ranked team in the Missouri Valley and know you can play better. I love these guys.
Yeah, again, I mean, you come on the road and beat a top 10 team. However you do it, it's pretty darn impressive.
It is. It is. And again, let's acknowledge, not whine about, but let's acknowledge the number of players we're missing. You know, starters that are injured and aren't able to play. They're not half speed. They're not on the bus. And so credit to our young guys. I mean, Tucker Large played Sam Backer today, nickel, and he started safety a couple games ago. So what a great job by him and a young guy. And I just love our football team and how they believe in themselves.
I always ask you, what are you happiest with today?
I really was happy with the way the offense moved the ball. You know, again, we need to finish, but I thought we had some crucial plays. I thought Isaiah and Amar ran really, really hard. Really happy with that.
What were you disappointed in today?
I was disappointed for Hunter. Dustman on the field goals. I mean, that would have changed the face of this game. You know, one, he has no choice, I don't think, because of the block. But the other two, he can make those kicks, and he's a winner. He came up to me afterwards. He said, you know, not a great day, but I'll be back. And I said, I know you will, Hunter, and we believe in you. So he'll be back, and he'll be even better.
Now you come on the road, get a big win. Now home, back-to-back week. So it'll start next week, Hall of Fame weekend against Western Illinois. I know you're excited to play back at Dana J. Dykal Stadium these next two Saturdays.
I'm excited. We'd love to have a crowd like we had the last two weekends at home. And it makes such a difference, and it's a great environment. And, again, I'm not giving the tickets away, but show up and be there and help make a difference.